Hey you guys, so I have my Smashbook here and I think I'm going to do my Smashbook share before I leave to Disneyland. The Facebook group that's called Smashaholics, I actually posted a picture of one of my pages that I was working on and saying that I was going to do a video afterwards, after I come back from Disneyland, which is going to be a Saturday. I'm going to be leaving tomorrow, which is Thursday here where I live. And so I just want to get this up right now. So that way, when I come back, I plan on actually just kind of letting you guys know how my trip went and kind of vlog about it, I guess. So this is the Smashbook. It's just a Disney one. And sorry about the really, it's really bright. It's like 9 o'clock in the morning here. And sorry for the angle. My tripod is acting up. I can't even, like, put it any lower than that. I'm, like, I don't know what's wrong with it. So, I need to buy a new one or try to get it fixed. But anyways, something's bothering me here. And it is... I'm sorry, there's just something... Oh, it's... Hey you guys, so I have my Smashbook here and I think I'm going to do my Smashbook share before I leave to Disneyland. The Facebook group that's called Smashaholics, I actually posted a picture of one of my pages that I was working on and saying that I was going to do a video afterwards, after I come back from Disneyland, which is going to be a Saturday. I'm going to be leaving tomorrow, which is Thursday here where I live. And so I just want to get this up right now. So that way, when I come back, I plan on actually just kind of letting you guys know how my trip went and kind of vlog about it, I guess. So this is the Smashbook. It's just a Disney one. And sorry about the really, it's really bright. It's like 9 o'clock in the morning here, so, And sorry for the angle. My tripod is acting up. I can't even, like, put it any lower than that. I'm, like, I don't know what's wrong with it. So, I need to buy a new one or try to get it fixed. But anyways, something's bothering me here. Sorry. I didn't like that. It was in my shot. Okay, so, again, this is the Disney Smashbook. It's the red one. And so I'm just going to go right to it. I've already showed you guys or told you guys what I did with the front, I believe. I'm not quite sure. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I did. And so I'm just going to go over it. Now, you see these pink tabs that are right here? They're just little post-it tabs. That means that I'm not quite done with it, but I'm still going to show you it. It's pretty done. I mean, pretty much done. I just need to add some information there. So that's all. The only reason why I have it there. So I'm going to get right to it. I already recorded this once, but I didn't like how it took forever for me to go through these pages, so I'm going to really try my best to get right to it. Okay, so for the first page, I just had a photo of my annual pass, so I just stuck that there. So I'm not, again, done with this page. I'm still going to add some more to it, but that's how that looks, and that's just on the vellum piece. I want to keep that in there. I already showed you this page. So this is my first page. This is going to be about Goofy. So this isn't only about my trips. This is going to be about the characters and just a little bit about them. So that way when I have kids and my kids start to grow up, they know about, you know, some of the information about Goofy that I knew. So I also went online in Wikipedia, sorry about that, just to kind of get some more information that I didn't know. So what I did for this image, you'll be seeing some large images like this. I just colored it with some Bic markers, and I traced with a tuxedo black marker. I traced the, I still have coloring books, so I traced the coloring book page onto some printer paper, and I colored it in afterwards, so I used that as a backdrop, pretty much. Then I used some confetti, punched confetti here that I punched out with my, just one of my inexpensive punches. It's not a quarter inch, though. It's a little bit bigger. Then I stamped some hearts with some orange ink by the paper company, I believe. And then I used some, what are those stickers? Tiny type letters, I believe. I'm not quite sure. I forgot who they were by. Cosmo Cricket. And so I used that on top of this little flag that I got from one of the journaling cards that I have. Then I used a Smash pocket, and this pocket actually comes with two pockets, so I made kind of my own inserts. So this one is actually just a die cut piece that I got from the EK Success die cut cardstock pack, and I didn't do anything to it. I actually really like the back of it, and just I love the glitter effect on the garish, and so that was really cute. So for this one here, this one's just some information about Goofy, kind of his name and all that. And this is what's going to be on most of the pages. There's going to be more on some of them, and just some, they don't have too many. So I stamped an image here, and I just colored it in again with my Bic Markets. And then that just stuck into my first envelope, or my first pocket. And then here, when I went to, or when I go to Disneyland or California Adventures, I always go to the Animation Academy, I believe. And I try to remember on how to draw Goofy. I do have my papers, so I kind of looked at it and kind of did it step by step as much as I could remember. So don't laugh. It doesn't look perfect, but that's what this card looks like. So what it is it just teaches you step by step on how to draw Goofy. Okay? And that is for my second pocket. So for this, for these letters, I use the JFK remark stickers by American Crafts, just to put Goofy's info. I put Goofy info. It makes sense because it's funny info. I mean, it's not really that funny, though. I didn't really put a lot, but I just already stuck it down, so I didn't want to worry about putting the S. But anyways, these three here, I got from one of those papers by Sandy Lion, which has all the poses. Each character has three poses. There's one where it's different, and then two that are the same, but one is flipped. So I used that on this page. This wasn't my first page. The first page I ever made was Mickey Mouse, but I'll be going through that. I'm just going to go right through this. And so I just backed it with black cardstock, and just to pop it off of this orange stripe. And I tried to coordinate the background with who I'm talking about. So I used this orange grid line on there. Okay, so that's how that page turned out. I'm just gonna stick this back in there. Okay. Then my next page is a princess page, so you could tell by all the pink. I didn't show you guys in my last haul video, but I got, let's see if I can get it here. Somewhere here. I'm not sure where it went, but I got the scrapbooking kit for the princess characters, and I got the Dazzle pack. So it was kind of like that one that I showed you for the my Mickey Mouse and all that other stuff. But I got the actual princess one. It was $9.99 for the papers and the Dazzles. So these are the Dazzles. They're actually gold. I can't find my paper stack, but I've used most of the papers. And this one comes with three sheets, but my other one is actually over there. I didn't pick it up. And so this is, I use them on this page. The thing about the Dazzles, there's some images, like this heart image, on the pattern papers that come with this, you can apply this on top of one of the patterns that shows this heart, and it fits perfectly. So that way you have a background for your heart. So I wish I could show you, but I have no idea where I put my paper stack. I know I had it somewhere here, I just don't remember exactly where. So sorry about that. But yeah, so this was one of the papers. I just cut her out, just a rectangular shape, and then I used some washi tape because this is a flap, and I used one of these cupcake toppers that was a princess hat that I actually have a lot of that I haven't used. So I used that as a little thing to flip it with, and then I used one of the die cut pieces here. I punched some butterflies, and then it flips open. And then here's some information about her. I did some doodling here. And then here's one of the Dazzles. It's really cute. It's like a little silhouette. And then I have just some punched pink vellum butterflies. And I put about three of those there. And then I have her little fairies that are with her. And then just her and some of the roses that she had, in her picture here just to match it. So this background piece here, and I also put some striped washi tape, sorry about that. And the pattern paper, just going way too fast here. I just don't want it to be too long, but the pattern paper here is from The Sweetest Thing by Recollections, and it's just a pretty floral, so I thought it was like perfect for this page. It kind of breaks the brightness of it. And then again, I used some dazzles, putting Sleeping Beauty in the crown. And then this background piece, I used some white cardstock, and my new distress ink is Victorian Velvet, which is a pretty like pink. Like, it's a purple pink. It's, like, perfect. I love it. And I used the crown, and I did the resist technique. So I thought it came out really cute. Okay, so that's what I have there. And then for my next page. So this is one of the pages that I haven't finished. So you can see here I have that pink tab that's on there. And this is about Cinderella. Again, I use the dazzles. So it just says Cinderella up there. And then this has the princess. I cut this out from one of the pattern papers that came with the paper stack again, or the dazzle stack. Scrapbooking kit. Oops. Sorry about that. And I use just one of those die cut pieces and some more dazzles. And what I mean by this, so you see this heart here? That could fit on one of these larger hearts. So something like this, or maybe that one fits on this one. But what you do is you put the dazzle on top of one of the patterns that fits this size. Oh, right here. There you go. And it kind of it gives it that background, and then it even has doodled, like, scallop edges to it. So I thought that was really cute. Like, you can just stick your sticker right on top, and it does all the work for you. So that way you don't have to do it yourself. So I thought that was cool. And then here I just used whatever was extra from this piece. It comes with two separate papers for each princess, which is only three princesses that it actually comes with. But I used the 6-inch piece, a 6-inch by 12-inch piece, and I made a little gatefold card. And then I just kind of, this isn't even done. I just need some information in, but this is how the inside looks. I used one of the dazzles there, and I put some purple cardstock, did some white faux stitching, and I put her die cut piece, and then with the birds. And then I used the mice that helped her get her dress done and everything. And I just, because these are single-sided papers, I adhered two pieces, so they measured, I believe, 6 1/8 by 12 inches, and then that closes up like that. And I just scored it at 3 and 6, so that way you can get a 6 by 6 square, kind of. So this one I actually used my Martha Stewart circle cutter, and I cut out a circle about 4 1/4 inches. And then I used a die cut piece, two die cut pieces here. I did some clear embossing with one of the stamps from the Princess EK Success stamp set. And then I did more dazzles, and I just kind of confettied it all over the place. So again, that's a gatefold card, and I mean piece, and again, I didn't finish it. So, and I thought that this was a perfect page. I love the purples and the pinks. It just went perfectly, and I like how I put, it says you look nice today, and it just says Cinderella, you look nice today. So this actually fits right underneath that. Okay, so that was that page. And then next page, I actually used my Heidi Swap folders. I told you that in my haul video that I was going to be using those in my book, and here goes one. This one actually had a map, and or like a map pattern right in front, but I ended up just covering it up with purple paint. So this is kind of like just a lilac color, and I used it for Daisy. This one is actually stuck on there. I didn't use the back side of it, but I will be posting a video after I show you one page about how I added this folder in to use the whole folder. Just for those of you that are beginners, because I know that a bunch of you probably already know how to do that, but I know that some people commented saying that they just started Smashbooking, so I kind of just want to show you how I did that. So this one I just used a doily. I used some chevron pattern papers to break up the brightness here, and then I used some pattern papers that also had some pastel colors, but it also had the black in it, just so that way it pops, you know, it makes all these other patterns pop off. I also did some just some outlining with a black pen, which is a smash pen, and I used these pieces here. This was actually a 12 by 12, and I just used my 1-inch circle punch to punch these out. And they look like little swirls, like roses. So I thought they were really cute. So I put that. I did a pattern paper here and punched out a butterfly. I have a journaling card here from a Recollections Creative Chaos stack. So I got that there. And then when you open it, so here's the folder. I actually kept the inside the way it is, and you could see that I got some of the purple paint on there, but it doesn't bother me. The reason why I adhered this down and I didn't use the back of it is because I didn't like the pattern with the bird, and I just had nothing to be able to cover it up. So again, here is one of the, what is that, the coloring book pages that I traced and I colored. So I did rough coloring. I wanted it to look like I did the coloring. I didn't print it off. So that I did, and then I punched out some flowers with just one of my flower punches. I outlined it with a purple Sharpie, put a gray dot in the middle with my Sharpie. Use washi tape. Again, I use it throughout the pages, so when you see it, that's what it is. And then this is something I just wrote out myself. It just says the Daisy Duck Files. Okay, and then this side, again, I used the three poses, and then because there's only three poses, but I wanted it to be a full square, I just created my own, and so I just decorated it and bring back the colors in from whatever was up front here, and I put it on to here. Okay, and then this was a journaling card. I just stamped her on to this journaling card. I have these, they're like graph paper type journaling cards, and I got this actually from a local local scrapbooking store. It's actually a local Japanese stationery store, so it was like $1.50. All their things are like $1.50, and if it's marked, then it means that it's a different price. But anyways, I just put a quote that she says, and she goes, "Oh goody," and then I just put Daisy Duck. This I made from one of the Amy Tangerine vellum sheets, and I made it so that way I can put a journaling card in there. This was from a Recollections, again, Creative Chaos journaling card set, and I used the Mickey Mouse punch to actually make a pull tab. So I cut two out, and then I adhered them both together, and then I used my heart stamp, and I stamped it, and I cut them out, and I put some dimension on it. As you could see, mine is actually getting fat. I know that I said I wasn't going to make it as bulky, but I just can't help myself but make it bulky. So I actually really love it. So I'm glad that it's getting thicker. It shows that I'm actually having fun with this. So anyways, I put some... Oops, there goes one page. I put some journaling, or not journaling, but some information about her. And then this one as well, I put some more information. And then that was it for Daisy Duck. Okay, so again, I use the folder. And I only use folders for the, just for the girly, like Minnie Mouse and Tinkerbell and all that. But the princesses, I actually make my own flaps, and the Goofy and everybody else, I'm going to just use pockets or just put it straight to the page. So, okay. Sorry if I'm rambling, I just, I'm really trying to get this under 30 minutes. So here is a page I actually used a photo on. So I did want to incorporate some photos. So this was a special day. This was during the Christmas time there. And I bought this sticker, and it was perfect for this. So they're watching the fireworks, so it came with some fireworks stickers. And so he has his arm wrapped over her, and I just thought it was the cutest thing. And so my loved one asked me to be his mini, so I thought it was just really cute. And it says, "A life worth living," so, you know, this page was perfect. And I love that the craft kind of was in the background, the neutral colors, because it made my photo pop. Because it is a little bit dark, but because I have the bokeh dots here, I love it. So here I use my punch. I use a heart punch, some rhinestones for the Minnie Mouse, and then again, I just left these as the Mickey Mouse heads. I use some baker's twine to hang them to look more like Christmas decorations, and then I pop them up so that way they're kind of popping up off the page. And then these letters are thickers. This one is Rockabye, and this one's Rockabye Marciando. Okay, so that was for that page. And you already seen this page. This one was my first page done. So this is where my boo-boo was, where I ripped off one of my pages, or the thing that I glued on top of here, one of my pattern papers that I glued on here. So I covered it up with some yellow cardstock and I did a Mickey page. So you can tell this was my first page because I didn't think that I was going to get very technical, well not technical, but be very creative with it. So adding folders and everything like that, I just kind of made it simple. So I made my own title, it just says Mickey, and then his favorite saying, which is a die cut, says, oh boy. I used one of the die cuts just for him, and just one pose when I could use three. That's how you can tell that I wasn't so into it. Well, not so into it, like, I just wasn't really thinking about putting a lot into it. And then here, some more information. And then I just used one of the, a speech bubble, and I stamped oh boy and aw shucks, and then I just put his little head punch there and some washi tape, and then I made a border strip using his little the head punch that I have. Okay, so that was for that page. And then this was one other page that I haven't finished. I just haven't put any information, but this is Beauty and the Beast. I didn't put the Beast, but I put the Princess, but I also kept kind of the title of the movie that she was in. So again, some more dazzles. It just says Beauty and the Beast. And I thought that this page was perfect. So it says, ideas are awesome. Long live ideas, just like a queen. But I crossed out queen and I stamped princess using my stamp set, my Disney princess stamp set. And then I used some really pretty dazzles. So this is the chandelier that they have in that they had in the Beast's castle. And then I put a die cut here, and then I used one of the pieces also to back it up. And then more die cut pieces. So these are all die cut pieces, and I just layered them just like that. Now these flowers here, I showed you this in my haul. So I have them all in this jar here. I just put them in this jar. I used just a water brush pen. I have this one here. And I used my Victorian velvet. And what I did was I watercolored on top of it. So the distressings act as a alcohol ink, kind of. And the ribbon took it, like the flowers, took the ink so well that it just matched perfectly. So I love this page. I really love it. I love how the gold and everything just blends in together, and yeah, that's how I did that. And so for this one, I actually used a die cut frame, and then I fussy cut these from a pattern paper that came with the dazzle set, and I backed it with some pink cardstock, and then I put dimensionals on the frame to pop it off. And you can see that this one's actually sinking in, but it doesn't bother me. It's because of the rose, so it doesn't really bother me, but I really love how this page turned out. So it's not done yet. I did some stamping also with a rose because how the Beast gave her a rose. So I really love how the roses and the flowers are just so pretty. So that was that page. And I'm going to go straight to the back here because this is where my video is going to come in. So this is my mini page. This is my Minnie Mouse page. And I chose this dark background because it is a little bit bright with this folder. So again, I used some washi tape, and then now you can use both sides, which are right here. So you can use the full-on folder. So, oops, that's the folder, like that. So I'm going to go over it first, and then I'll put the video in. But this, so what I did was, this was my second page, and this is when I realized that I actually started loving how it looks with all of these layers and just, you know, getting really creative with it. So I did some of that glitter splashing with some watered down glue and putting some glitter on there. And I did some black splatters with some black spray inks. I used a doily, and I just grabbed some scrap papers, and I just layered it on top of each other. Then I added sequins and some leftover felt hearts that I actually made for a gift, but I had some left over, so I used them there. And then die cuts, and then some more of the little Mickey Mouse heads that I used with gray cardstock. And I used pink vellum with my heart punch here, and I use a rhinestone to keep those together to make a bow, which I've been doing. And for the side here where the tab is, I just use some more of those Rockabye thickers to put mini. Then it opens up, and then again I used three of those poses, and I like how this one actually is pink in the background. So I used those and I backed it with black cardstock, and they fit perfectly across here. I made my own little journaling type card looking thing, and I just layered some pattern papers. I outlined it, put some washi tape, and I used my Martha Stewart's alphabet punch to make to put out Minnie Mouse on there. This was the negative from one of my felt hearts, and I used a die cut piece to put her right in the center, which fit perfectly, which I love. This was supposed to be a photo corner, but had an extra one, so I just stuck it there. And again, I just used that punch, and I put glitter on top of there, just so that way it has a different look. And I used Glossy Accents as the glue to stick the glitter on there. Okay, and then this one I actually put a photo in of myself. Because I had the Minnie Mouse ears, I thought it was just appropriate for this page. So I put the M for Minnie Mouse, which was a leftover chipboard piece that I had, which was the negative. And then I used some more negative pieces here. I outlined it with a black pen, did more splattering here, doilies, and I just pretty much scattered pattern papers and vellum behind. And then here, again, I used, I made photo corners, so I cut the head in half, and then I used Glossy Accents. I don't know if my phone is catching that. But I used Glossy Accents on here, and what I did was I put some glitter on one of them, two of them, but I only used three because this one was covering the other corner, so I just have these two here and then this one there. Okay, so that's that one there, and then the back of the folder, I just wrote down Minnie Mouse with my markers, my Bic markers. And then I used some more of those alphas, which are the remark stickers. And I did some doodling around it. And then I used just some asterisks right here. Okay. And then, again, the coloring book page thingy that I drew, or I traced and colored. So this is the whole this is where you can actually use the whole Heidi Swap folder, and I'm going to put a video in right now to show you how I put this in. Okay, so this isn't really going to be like a full page tutorial. This is just going to show you what I'm going to do with the folders, because I did say in my haul that I was going to show you what I'm going to do with it. So these are the Heidi Swap memory files that I showed you in my haul, and I chose to use this pink one right here, and you'll see why I chose that. And I was thinking that of putting it on some kind of page that has white on it, so this page here that has the doodled grid lines, I was going to use that piece here for this, but I didn't really like how it kind of just blended in kind of with the folder, so I kind of went for a darker background. I flipped through the whole thing before I actually committed to this page here, and I know this looks a little bit dark, but the colors I'm going to be using on this folder are going to be very bright. I'm going to be using the die cuts that are from EK Success, and so I already have them in a bowl, which is where I put all my die cuts when I work. And I also have some washi's because I'm going to show you how to make how I'm going to put the folder in here. I'm pretty sure that a lot of you guys know how to. I'm just going to do these for those of you that are beginners or just starting to make Smashbooks. So the folder I wanted to open, I was going to glue this whole back side down here, but I don't want to waste the folder. And what I mean by that is I don't want to waste this really, really pretty distressed pattern. And I really love the pink that's on here. And the die cut I'm going to be using is the Minnie Mouse die cut because it is going to be about Minnie. So I want to use this pink one. And I really like the back, I just wish that it was a separate die cut, but anyway, I'm going to be using this one, and it's going to be on here, and you can see that, you know, the pink is a little bit different, but it just brings in that girly-ish feel to it. So that's one reason why I want to use this page here, is because this is not all black. If you really look at the page, it's actually pink. So the flowers are pink, and it has some of this aqua color, which is right here. It has some of that also brought in here. So what I'm going to do is just show you quickly what I'm going to do with the folder. So I want to be able to have some space to actually, like, put my tape, because I'm going to just be using some washi tape. And I'm going to be using that to adhere this down to make kind of like a flap, so that way it's an extra page. And so that way I can use the back, the front, and the insides. And I love the inside too, the chevron. It's just really cute. I might go back to get more of these. But anyways, so I'm going to use, I'm not sure if I want this darker pink or this lighter pink. And so I'm going to use this piece to put the folder inside. Hopefully you guys can see this. So I'm going to just place a long strip along the edge of the folder. I don't know if it's, you can see, but I have a pretty good amount of it, of tape onto my file folder. So I'm just gonna place where I want this, and it's gonna be stuck there. And I'm gonna put this point all the way to the edge of the binding. And I'm gonna really press this into there. And I'm just gonna use a bone folder to get along there. Okay. And these pieces here, you can just tear that off. Or use your scissors, because someone's not tearing off for me. And I like to leave it. So I just tore off that strip there, but I kept that adhered onto there still. So that one should be fine. And then same for the back. You're going to do the exact same thing, just by adding a strip of washi tape. That should be good. So I'm just going to clean up these edges just a little bit. Okay. And if you want, you can double up the tape to make sure that this isn't going to come off, but I'm not going to worry about that, because I'm pretty sure that it's going to stay there. So I'm just really pushing into the tape here. And I'm just going to go into the center and really press on there. And then now it's ready to go. So you can reinforce it by adding another strip of washi tape to the center of this. I'm not sure. I don't know. I'll think about it. I'm not really sure, but that's how I'm going to be adding these manila folders, or not manila folders, these memory files into my book. I'm not sure if I'm going to use all six of them. That will add a lot of bulk to my book, which is pretty good, but I don't think I'm going to put so many of those. And it's going to stick out of your folder, but that makes it, you know, your folder very fun and just, you know, smashy looking. So that's how I add my folders in. I just use some washi tape and I just put it on both sides. And now you can use the whole folder and still have this pattern showing through the back. So I hope that this helped you guys and gave you some inspiration. And thanks for watching.
Okay, so hopefully that helped some of you guys out. For those of you guys that are beginners, or some of you guys that just didn't know, you know, how to do that. So I'm going to go on to the next page. So this one's about Little Mermaid. I used some thickers. I don't remember what kind these ones were, but these were, I actually got from Marshall's, and I just didn't have enough space to fit her the name in, because I already had these glued down, so I just adhered this on top of the E and the M, so it actually gives it some dimension, which is really cute. And then these ones are just some EK Success letters that I got from Target that I had left over. And because she is underwater, I made bubbles using vellum and some just pattern papers that I stuck vellum on top of to just tone it down a little bit. And then I used a white gel pen to give it the little bubbly look to it. I don't know if you could see it. It's right there. Okay, and then I stamped her here because I wanted one more because I've been doing three poses for most of them. So I just did, I stamped her, I colored her in with watercolor pencils, and then I put some glitter on top of her hair, which is just some glitter glue here. That's the Studio G glitter glue. And then this was from one of the pattern papers that I showed in my haul. I just fussy cut her, and then I used my X-Acto knife to get in these little grooves here, and then some more die cut pieces that I got from my Princess Disney cardstock paper stacks, and then some information. Then I used some paint, and I sprayed it with water, and just to water it down, and then I used my paintbrush and just dragged it all over and just let it drip however far it went, and then let it dry overnight. I know I even have to wait overnight, but just because I was going to class, I just let it dry overnight, and I was too tired when I got home. I usually get home like at 10:30 at night or 11, so I usually just don't, I usually just lay in bed and just not worry about it and worry about it until the next day. So this is going to be a page, and it says I'm awesome because, but this is going to be a page about Donald Duck, so I just stuck it here. I haven't worked on it, so I didn't really mark it with one of my post-its, but here's another folder. This time I used like a darker flourish instead of a brighter one. It's because she's so pastel, like she's so like very colorful with her colors. So I wanted something a little bit darker so that way she can pop off. So again, I have some poses from the pattern papers that I showed you in my haul video. And some more of those roses that I kept white. I did some scrap pieces of pattern papers and layered it on top. I did, again, outlining. Even on the folder, I did outlining. I put a doily, some stickers that I had left over from my stash that I found. And I didn't show another haul video. I did go shopping a couple days ago. I have got these 3D stickers that are Tinkerbell stickers from Joann's. And I'll show you the other ones inside that I used. And so I thought they were really cute. And I'll just show you after I show you this. So this, I used some Amy Tangerine thickers in her Scenic collection, I believe. And they're just the silver glitter. And then here's the inside. So for this page, I just put Miss Bell Info. And so that's her little nickname. And I thought that was really cute. So it made it easy because it was already a just in the scrapbooking paper. And all of these came from a 12x12. And I still have a lot of her sayings left over. But I just used this I got from a Dollar Tree a couple days ago, and they were Tinkerbell stickers, and so I used one just to put it on the corner here. Did some information with some a purple Sharpie, used some extra circle letters and put follow your heart, and then I used another photo and I matted them with gray cardstock just to pop them off of the background here. And these are the stickers. They're just really cute. They're 3D, so they have dimension. And they were all separated, but I connected them together, and I just thought they were really cute. So, put those there. This page I'm impressed about. I used the Dear Lizzie jar stamp, and I just used some gel medium and some of my nail decoration type things to fill inside of there, so it's very, like, shiny. This one I just used some paint, and I swirled three colors together. This one I did glitter, and I just let it dry overnight. So I let all of these dry overnight. This one I used gel medium to stick on there so that way they stick really good. This one I just used some, I think it's quick dry, yeah. Quick dry adhesive by Scotch, and then this one's just paint. And then here I did some polka dots using the back of my brush. This one I used the glue and swirled it, and then this one I just adhered down with some quick dry adhesive. And then these are supposed to be like different kinds of pixie dusts. So this one says, a little pixie dust goes a long way, which is perfect. So I loved that sentiment that was on the pattern paper. And then here I just stamped with some Seafoam Green Ink by Recollections. I stamped Pixie Perfect, and then I outlined it, and I went over it with Victorian Velvet. And I outlined it with a black pen, some more of those dollar stickers, and some purple cardstock on the bottom of it. So for the back of this is the last page, I believe, that I actually worked on. So I'm already at 31 minutes, so plus the video. So hopefully this doesn't take forever to load. But this is the last part of it. So here's just some photo paper. What I did was I used four different colors. I put them all in a line, and what I did was I just smushed it or put water on top of it, and then I smushed it with just a clear protector sheet, and this is what it came out to. And it's just a really soft background. I used just photo paper that I had, and it came out differently than it would with cardstock. So I really love the way that this turned out. So this is perfect technique for like art journaling or something like that. But this was the largest photo that was on that pattern paper. So I just stuck that down here onto some black cardstock and then put it onto this piece that I made. And this is just a 4x6 card, photo card. And then here are the dollar stamps, and these are just her friends, so I thought I'd include them. And then here's one of her from the dollar stamps. And then these are just, and oh, there's another dollar stamp. I mean, not stamp. I keep saying stamp, but stickers. But these ones are some, because there still is a lot of other sayings that I have left over on my, just my one 12x12 that I've been getting all these images and all these sayings. I still have some left over. So it's perfect for just other projects. So I cut these all out separately and individually, and I just scatter them around to make them fit on the page, but like also have different colors in different areas. And I popped up some of the sayings that are just really cute that I just think of Disney right away once I hear it. And so I backed it with black cardstock so it pops up some more, and I've used some dimensional adhesive to stick that up there. Okay, so that is all for my Smashbook for now. That was a lot of information that I had to get in between at least 30 minutes, so I am 3 minutes ahead. I did want to do a card tutorial. I might do that on a separate video, or I might just add that to this video. But I hope that the tutorial that I showed you for the folder helped you guys out, and I hope that this inspired you guys to do a theme journal, because theme journals are just really fun. I loved having a theme journal. I know Smashbooks aren't supposed to be like that, but sometimes, you know, Smashbooks don't always have to go the way that it has to be. You could be creative and just do it your own way. So again, thanks for watching. I hope that this helped you guys out, and sorry for all the rambling, and yeah, bye.